स्टूडेंट्स, द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट इज द सिमिलैरिटी ऑफ ट्राइंगल. बट बिफोर वी गो फॉर द सिमिलैरिटी, एज यू कैन सी दैट हियर आई हैव रिटन द रिलेशन ऑफ द कॉन्ग्रुएंस बिटवीन द टू ट्राइंगल्स. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्ग्रुएंट मीनिंग ऑल्सो, देन वील मूव टूवर्ड्स द सिमिलैरिटी. बिकॉज टू अंडरस्टैंड द सिमिलैरिटी, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू क्लियर अबाउट द कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्राइंगल्स. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस with one of the example which I have right now. You can see that here, that is one triangle which is in my hand, that is triangle PQR, that you can see here, it's a triangle PQR. But you can see that I have one more triangle here just behind it, that is triangle XYZ also. So why these two triangles? As I mentioned that I want to show the correspondence, congruence. So you can see that when I put this triangle PQR over the XYZ, so this both the triangles are overlapping. So you can see that they are overlapping to each other. Overlap ho raha hai, matlab exact measurement hai. So we can say that these two triangles are congruent. But remember here, you can see that where these two triangles are congruent. So here you can see that XYZ is congruent to QRP. Why I have written QRP, I have not written PQR. So here we discuss that angle X is congruent with Q and Y congruent with R and Z congruent with P. So this called their corresponding angles. So the word corresponding angles and corresponding sides are very important. Let us understand again with the same that which I have explained here through the graph. You can see here what are the corresponding angles and corresponding sides I want to discuss. As I mentioned that this angle Z is corresponding with angle P. Why they correspond? You can see thus measurements are equal. The same way X is overlapping, that is the angle X and Q are same. The same for this, that is Y and R are equal. Now if I just want to change this, if I want to, can I say that X is same as, kya main bol sakta hun ki angle X or P same hai? तो यहां पे यू कैन सी दैट दे आर नॉट ओवरलैपिंग एंड इवन यू कैन सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द टू एंगल्स वो सेम नहीं आ रहे. तो यहां पे वी कम टू द कंक्लूजन और वी अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ करस्पॉन्डेंस. तो क्यों एक्स के साथ क्यू करस्पॉन्ड्स कर रहे हैं? बिकॉज यू कैन सी दैट द रेस्ट ऑफ द एंगल्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. क्यों आर के साथ वाई करस्पॉन्ड्स कर रहे हैं? अगर मैं यहां पे If I say Y and P corresponders, you can see they are not overlapping. So it is very important to understand the correspondence between the triangles. So yahan pe, when we can say the two triangles are congruent, if the corresponding angles are equal, as we can see, and corresponding sides also. You can see that this XY is same as QR, this YZ is same as PR, and the third PQ is same as XY. See, remember students, this is very important to understand the corresponding sides. The same way, we have one more diagram for the same. You can see that. Here a triangle we have, that the name of the triangle is LMN. One more triangle is just behind it, that is the triangle DEF. The same way you can see this both are the right angle triangles. So here this angle is right angle D, the same way L. So they are correspondents. The same way E corresponds with N and this F is corresponds with M. Agar main isko change kar do, if I'll try to change this, you can see they won't overlap with each other. So this is another examples of correspondence. So remember students, correspondence word is very important to understand. So thus, let's, as we discuss that, the corresponding sides and corresponding angles, when they are equal, so we can say the given two triangles are congruent triangles. Now let us discuss about the similar triangles, or we can discuss about the similarity of triangles. So let's understand the similarity of triangles or two similar triangles. So you can see here, I have the two triangles in my hand. That is one triangle, that is LMN. Which is the larger one, you can see this L, M, N, and another is the smaller, that is ABC. This both are the right angle triangles. So you can see the first of all the angles or corresponding angles I want to show that. So you can see that when I merge A and N, you can see this both the angles are same, they are overlapping. That means the measure of angle A and angle N are same, as you can see that I have written here also. Now let's go for the second one, that I want to show the two or second angle, that is angle B is corresponds with the angle L. So you can see here this angle B that is equals to that is angle L. B or L angle dono same hai. You can see here this both are right angles, so they are overlapping to each other. And the third one, you can see that angle C and angle M, they are equal measured. So here, as I mentioned here in the diagrams, the same I have written here for you, that is A is same as N, B is same as L, and C is same as M. Now we know the sides are not equal. यहाँ पे जो हमने देखा वहां पे sides equal नहीं है. So now you look at this in the paper which I have, the graph, that is which I cut in the form of triangle. Now look at this AB which is of 4 and LN which is of 8. The same way you can see that BC is 3 and LN that is 6, and the third one that MN is 10 and AC is 5. Now when I'll do the ratio of the sides, that you can observe here. If I'll do AB upon LM, you can see that AB upon LN, so it is 4 by 8, that is 1 by 2. If I'll go for BC upon LM, that is 3 by 6, 1 by 2. And AC upon MN, that is 5 by 10, that is again 1 by 2. So here you can see that the two conditions, that means the ratios of this corresponding sides. See, corresponding sides, again that word I am using, the corresponding sides. मैं AB upon LN करूंगा, then only I can get 1 by 2. तो angle A is corresponding with N, B is corresponding with L, the same way in the side that AM upon LN is 1 by 2, BC upon LM is 1 by 2, the same way. So when the ratio of these three sides are equal, you can see that. So we can say that triangle ABC, this is the symbol of similarity, is similar to triangle NLM. So you can see that A is corresponds with N, B is corresponds with L, and C is corresponds with M. The same way AB upon LN, BC upon LM, and AC upon NM are same. So I hope students you understand the correspondence angles and corresponding sides in the similar triangles. So let's move further towards the theorem 6.1. Let's take one more example to understand the similarity of triangles, then we'll move towards the theorem. Now here I have the two triangles here, you can see that. One triangle is PQR, which you can see, and another is DEF. Now let's see that whether they are similar or not, and if they are similar, then which are the corresponding angles and corresponding sides. Let's match the corresponding angle. You can see that is P is matching with D, to nahi ho raha hai. Let us say that is P matching with E, so we can say yes. So that is, we can see here that P and E, they are overlapping, so these are the two, so we can say that P is same as E. So now let us see that which another sides or angles. Now this is also overlapping. You can see that R and F, they are overlapping, and Q and D, they are overlapping. So you can see that these are the three equal angles, we can see that, or not equal angles, hence corresponding angles. Which are the corresponding angles? P corresponds with E, Q corresponds with D, and R corresponds with F. So, can we say that this Q and E, they are corresponding angles? No, they are not overlapping. Can Q corresponds with F also? No, they are not overlapping. So, I hope students you are understanding that which are the corresponding angles. So, let us see again that which angles are corresponding and how we can write that they are the similar triangles. So P is equals to E, Q is equals to D, and R is equals to F. Let's start with the theorem 6.1, which is considered as one of the most important theorem. The theorem is known as basic proportionality theorem, that is BPT. It is also known as a Thales theorem because the mathematician Thales has derived this. So now let's see the statement, what the question is. Students, remember, you have to remember the statement also. Sometimes in the exams it has come that state basic proportionality theorem and prove it. So you have to remember the statement also, as it looks very lengthy, but it's quite understandable. It's not so difficult. So let us read out. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, so here you can see that in triangle ABC, line L is parallel to BC. That is what we read it. A line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. So L is parallel to BC, which I have written in the data also. To intersect the other two sides in distinct points, it intersect AB and AC at point D and E respectively. Okay. The other two sides are, this is what we have to prove. The other two sides are this point which divide this into the two part AD and BD, and this point divide AC in two parts AE and C. We have to show that they divide in the same ratio. So this is what we have to prove. Let's read it again. If a line drawn in a triangle which is parallel to one side of a triangle and intersect the other two sides at two distinct points, the point which divide the side and the two part of the sides, it should remain in the same ratio. So remember, the condition is what? The line must be parallel to any of the side of the triangle, and it should divide the rest of the two sides of a triangle at two distinct points. तो यहाँ पे जो point ये side को divide कर रहा है, that is AD and BD, उसका जो ratio होगा is same as AE upon CE. This is what a basic proportionality theorem. So let's see, students, how we'll prove this. We'll prove this. It's very easy to do this. तो हम क्या करेंगे students? हम यहाँ पे कुछ नाम याद रखेंगे. The names are very easy. The name is अड़े बड़े, अड़े सड़े. It's quite interesting to remember. मैं लिख रहा हूँ यहाँ पे. You should remember this. I am using the word अड़े बड़े, then अड़े एंड सड़े. So it's quite interesting to remember the name. अड़े बड़े, अड़े सड़े. So if you remember this name, then it's quite easy to do this theorem. Okay. Before we go to the proof, let us recall what is the formula to find out the area of a triangle. So area of any triangle, we know that half into its corresponding base into height or altitude, we can say. So we are going to use this formula, area of triangle, to prove this proportionality theorem. मगर यहाँ पे कहीं पे altitude या perpendicular दिख ही नहीं रहा. So what I'll do, I'll draw two perpendicular from point D to AC. This is one perpendicular. Let me give that M. And another perpendicular from E to AB. That is, I'll give N. So what I have constructed here, construct DM, which is perpendicular to AC. DM is perpendicular to AC. And EN, which is perpendicular to AB. Now, let us come back to here. That is the name at the beginning. हमने याद रखा था अड़े बड़े, अड़े सड़े. तो हम ये चारों ट्राइंगल्स की एरिया ढूंढेंगे. सो एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल ए डी ई, सो एज वी डिस्कस, इट इज हाफ इनटू करस्पॉन्डिंग बेस इनटू हाइट. तो व्हेन आई सी द ट्राइंगल ए डी ई, हम ट्राइंगल ई डी की बात कर रहे हैं, तो यहां पे दो एल्टीट्यूड है, एक डीएम और एक ई एन. सो लेट्स टेक एनी ऑफ दिस. हम पहले ई एन लेते हैं. सो उसका बेस होगा एडी, हाफ इंटू बेस इज एडी एंड द हाइट इज ई एन. मैंने यहां पे दिस इज द ट्राइंगल एडी एंड सॉरी एडीई ट्राइंगल आई एम टॉकिंग, जिसमें एडी बेस है और ई एन एल्टीट्यूड है. दूसरा ट्राइंगल क्या लेना है, दैट इज बड़े. सो एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल बड़े, दैट इज बीडी. दिस इज क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग टू फाइंड आउट द एरिया. बीडीई, लेट मी ज्वाइन दिस बी, हम इसको ज्वाइन कर. सो व्हेन आई सी हियर, यहां पे मैं एक रफ डायग्राम ड्रॉ कर रहा हूं टू एक्सप्लेन दिस. इट्स बी डी ई. अब फॉर दिस ट्राइंगल एडी, ई एन इज एन एल्टीट्यूड, मगर ये ट्राइंगल में हमें कहीं पे एल्टीट्यूड नहीं दिख रहा है. वी कैन नॉट फाइंड आउट एनी एल्टीट्यूड. मगर आप अच्छे से ध्यान करो, इफ आई एक्सटेंड दिस बी डी, सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज एन एल्टीट्यूड. सो रिमेंबर स्टूडेंट्स, अगर मैं कोई ट्राइंगल को इस तरह से ड्रॉ कर रहा हूं, इफ इट इज एन ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल ट्राइंगल एंड इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट, वेर बी इज एन ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल विच इज ग्रेटर देन 90. नाउ इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट एन एल्टीट्यूड फ्रॉम वर्टेक्स ए टू बी सी, तो मुझे इसको एक्सटेंड करना पड़ेगा एंड दिस वुड बी द एल्टीट्यूड. रिमेंबर, तो यहां पे कुछ इसी तरह है. डी वी शुड कंसिडर एज एन ऑब्ट्यूज, सो ई एन इज एन एल्टीट्यूड बिकॉज एन इज अ पॉइंट विच इज ऑन एक्सटेंडेड ऑफ बी डी. सो यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दिस. अगर समझ में नहीं आ रहा तो यू कैन रिवाइंड इट एंड अंडरस्टैंड दिस अगेन, वॉट द कंसेप्ट आई एक्सप्लेन. सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू द डायग्राम. तो व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट दिस ट्राइंगल बी डी ई, तो यहां पे लिखेंगे हाफ बेस, तो हम लिखेंगे यहां पे बेस बी डी है एंड विच इज एन एल्टीट्यूड दैट इज ई एन. इतना करने के बाद स्टूडेंट्स यू शुड रिमेंबर, हमें इन दोनों का रेशियो करना है. तो हम करेंगे एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल एडी अपॉन एरिया ऑफ ट्राइंगल बी डी, दैट इज हाफ इंटू एडी इंटू ई एन एंड हाफ इंटू बी डी इंटू ई एन. सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व हियर दैट हाफ इज कैंसल एज वेल एज ई एन कैंसल. सो वॉट वी ऑप्टेन एडी अपॉन बी डी, दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एरिया ऑफ एडी. लेट मी जस्ट नोट इट डाउन हियर. This value is equals to area of AD upon area of BD, that is AD upon BD. This is what I obtain. I'll give it as an equation number 1. So we have to obtain the second equation, the same for this triangle, that is ade and sade. हमने अड़े बड़े के लिए obtain कर दिया ratio. Same we have to go for the ade sade. So let us go for the same way. That area of triangle AD, अब दोबारा वही ADE. Now this time we'll take altitude DM, तो उसका base होगा AE. So half into AE into DM. The second triangle is CD, E, SADE, CD. So as I explained here for BD, the same way I'll join this. So the same way we can consider CE is the base and DM is an altitude. So half into CE into DM. Again I'll go for the ratio. So here students I'll note it down directly. मैं यहां पे थोड़ा direct लिख रहा हूं. Method which I'll explain here that I'm not going to do. When I'll do the ratio, मैं इन दोनों का ratio करूंगा तो ये half cut होगा, ये DM cut होगा. So I'll get AE upon C. My equation number 2. अगर मैं equation 1 और 2 को compare कर दूं तो मेरा थ्योरम प्रूव हो जाएगा. बट व्हेन आई कैन कंपेयर द राइट हैंड साइड इफ द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड मस्ट बी इक्वल. बट लुक एट द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, न्यूमरेटर्स आर सेम बट द डिनोमिनेटर्स आर डिफरेंट. यहां पे है बी डी ई और यहां पे है सी डी ई. बट रिकॉल द नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड, हमने नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड में कुछ ऐसा पढ़ा था कि इफ देर आर टू ट्राइंगल्स लाई बिटवीन द टू पैरेलल साइड्स हैविंग कॉमन बेस हैव इक्वल एरिया. एक थियरम था दैट वॉज फॉर द क्वाड्रिलेटरल, वो पैरेलोग्राम के लिए था. बट आफ्टर दैट वी डिस्कस दैट ऑल्सो, हमने ये भी सीखा था कि इफ देर आर टू ट्राइंगल्स लाई बिटवीन द टू पैरेलल्स, यहां पे डीई और बीसी पैरेलल है, दोनों ट्राइंगल का कॉमन है डीई विच इज कॉमन, तो हम यहां पे बोल सकते हैं कि एरिया ऑफ बी डी ई इज सेम एज एरिया ऑफ सी डी ई. वॉट इज द रीजन दैट वी हैव टू मेंशन? बिकॉज ट्राइंगल बी डी ई एंड ट्राइंगल सी डी ई दे लाई बिटवीन पैरेलल्स. विच आर द पैरेलल्स? डी ई एंड बी सी एंड हैव कॉमन बेस सी बी, दैट इज कॉमन बेस डी ई. सो दिस इज द रीजन विच यू हैव टू मैंशन. सो फ्रॉम 1, 2 and 3, फ्रॉम 1, 2 and 3 इक्वेशन विल कम टू द डराइवेशन. हमने बता दिया लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इक्वल है तो राइट हैंड साइड भी इक्वल ही होगा. सो वी कैन से दैट ए डी अपॉन बी डी इज सेम एज ए अपॉन सी. दस वी प्रूव द थियरम. स्टूडेंट्स रिमेंबर दिस इज द सिंबल ऑफ फुल स्टॉप ऑफ थियरम विच वी हैव टू डू एट द एंड ऑफ दिस थियरम. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड. थैंक यू.